Good afternoon and welcome. Welcome, St. Petersburg College faculty, staff, guests, family, and graduates. The St. Petersburg College Student Nurses Association is proud to present this pinning ceremony in honor of the RN graduating class of December 8, 2016. I would first like to thank everyone for joining us today. My name's Richard Higgins, and I have the honor of serving as the president of the St. Petersburg College Student Nurses Association. I'm humbled to be able to represent you today. Graduates, it's been a long journey. We've taken the first step in pursuing our dreams to become compassionate and empathetic nurses, while at the same time securing a career with infinite possibilities. So it is with decreased cardiac output, related to altered heart rate, secondary to public speaking, as evidenced by palpitations, exertional dyspnea, and verbalization of weakness that I stand here today. So do you remember that first day of nursing school? We went around the room introducing ourselves and reading the syllabus. Day two, hand hygiene. Day three, blood pressures and temperatures. The instructors were all looking at us going, "Isn't this fun? Isn't nursing school easy?" Then all of a sudden, day four. We have 16 chapters to read, a two-hour care plan to do, case studies, wellness plan, IPA, learn med, sim chart, and start practicing for the NCLEX that's still 2 years away. And I don't think that pace stopped until a couple of days ago. It's amazing how quickly diet and exercise fall by the wayside in nursing school, too. I have to admit, I gained a little girth in the abdomen. I've heard it's called student belly. And I think it's contagious. Anybody else here get student belly? Student thigh? Student butts? I have tiny little student biceps I can show you, too. And how about the books? I've never bought 300 pounds of books before. Tell you to just go to the bookstore and buy the bundle. To me, a bundle is something small. I went to the bookstore and got this bundle, and they asked me if I had a truck. So just pull it around front, and we'll help you load it in for you. And how many, raise your hands if you have those rolling milk carts. See, there you go. You got med-surg books, fundamentals books, farm books, drug guides books, lab books, OBGYN books, PEDS books, medical dictionary, psych books, nursing made easy books, nursing made not so easy books. And these aren't your typical 200-page textbooks. They're the King James versions. And our friends wonder why we haven't been outside in 2 years. I'm not afraid to go outside, I'm just a nursing student. So then we finally had our first clinical day. That special day when we'd actually get to take care of real people. When we'd deal with loose bowels, urine, sweat, vomiting, and difficulty breathing. And that was just us before we went to the floor. And we also learned to self-diagnose ourselves. Social isolation, stress overload, sleep deprivation, acute confusion, ineffective coping, fatigue, and impaired memory. Every stomach pain was a peptic ulcer. Or I'm sweaty and weak, what's my blood sugar? My arm's twitching, do I have enough magnesium? And then we got to psych class. And I've been antisocial lately, and I do hear voices telling me to shut off Game of Thrones and finish my care plan. After that last test, I think I need to be checked for dementia, too. And the exams. It was probably the biggest stress of nursing school. Stress, signs and symptoms, low energy, headaches, upset stomach, nausea, aches, pains, tense muscles, chest pain, and rapid heartbeat. Insomnia, frequent colds, and infection. Anyone relate? You know, here's the real part, though. We have to keep our sense of humor. We're going into a field where we'll be surrounded by death and disease, so we need to be able to laugh. So when friends ask those not in nursing school, would you do it all again? My answer is, I wouldn't do it all over again, but I wouldn't not do it once. You see, the experiences we've had in nursing school and the ways that we've grown and the relationships that we've made with our patients, our colleagues, our mentors, these we should not trade for anything in the world. As we go our separate ways tonight, realize that unless we care for ourselves and each other, as professionals and as friends, we cannot hope to hold on to the compassion that our patients deserve. A touch of empathy and a smidgen of humor will go such a very long way for our careers. Ralph Waldo Emerson said, "To laugh often and love much, to win the respect of intelligent persons and the affection of children, to earn the approbation of honest citizens and endure the betrayal of false friends, to appreciate beauty, to find the best in others, to give of oneself, to leave the world a bit better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or a redeemed social condition, to have played and laughed with enthusiasm and sung with exultation, to know even one life has breathed easier because you have lived, this is to have succeeded." We would be remiss to overlook the faculty and staff. To the faculty, we thank you for sharing yourselves with us. We thank you for laughing with us and for being there when we cried ourselves silly. It was always clear that you were invested in us and that you wanted us to succeed, from the exam-induced orthostatic hypotension to the hours of tachycardia that was a clinical day. We were never not protected, not cared for, or not advocated for. When we hemorrhaged emotions, you were the derma bond to our total and utter spiritual exsanguination. You taught us what's going to help the patients the most and what's going to kill them the quickest. We will always hear your voices and your sayings as we move forward. Thank you. Please give a resounding round of applause to our teachers, our mentors, our friends. Next, an acknowledgement to our families, our friends, our significant others. Thank you for going to nursing school with us. Thank you for listening to us. Thank you for letting us practice our skills on you. Thank you for putting up with us. Thank you for any and every single thing you did to help us accomplish this dream and this journey. Not a single one of us could have done it without your help and support. We would not be here without your love, support, and encouragement throughout the nursing program. So please give yourselves a big round of applause. Class, I can't thank you enough. All the inside jokes and nicknames, thank you for being us. Thank you for being the faces I can tolerate at midnight after a third 12-hour day in a row. I couldn't have asked for a more generous and genuine group to be a part of. It's been an honor to walk alongside you on this journey and to change with you. We are each of us unique and individually beautiful, and the world is going to benefit from every single one of us being in the career that we are going into now. Never stop learning, never stop growing. Strive to be more. Be kind to the students you meet. Respect your elders. Never lose sight of the empathy and care for others that made you get into this program in the first place. Thank you for letting me represent you today. I admire you all for your perseverance and courage, and I'm proud to be here with each and every one of you for your accomplishments. So, graduate nurses of America, class of fall 2016, You've made it. You're here. I would like to make a few introductions and acknowledgments. I'd like to introduce Associate Provost Dr. Nancy Kelly. Our Provost Dr. Eric Carver. The Dean of our Nursing Program, Dr. Susan Baker. I would also like to acknowledge the level chairs, Ms. Anna Nuzel, level one chair. Mrs. Jackie Hawkins Johnson, level two chair. Ms. Rebecca Keeney, level three chair. And Mrs. Virginia Schneider, level four chair. These administrators have been by our side, dedicated to us as students, and have helped to get us to this point. Thank you. As president of the Student Nurses Association, I am but a small part of the executive board. I would like to recognize our officers for all their dedication and hard work. Will the current Student Nurses Association officers please stand? Thank you for your commitment and time. And will the Student Nurses Association faculty advisors please stand? We have Ms. Joanne Goot, with much help from Dr. Joni Melville, and the chair of the Student Affairs Committee, Mr. Jacob Schwab. SNA would be lost without you. Thank you. We have a professional photographer here with us today who will be taking pictures of each graduate being pinned and will also be available for pictures following the ceremony. Now I would like to welcome our Dean of Nursing, Dr. Susan Baker. Dr. Baker.
Good afternoon. This is the most exciting day of the year for me. To be able to stand and watch the fall 2016 graduates come into the building is just an exciting and wonderful time. This is like one of the most awesome days. You should be so proud of yourselves, of the work that you've done, of the accomplishments that you've made, and the milestones that you've reached. Give yourselves a hand for the work that you've done. I know this hasn't been an easy journey, but you've persevered, you've stayed the course, and you're now here to bask in the fruits of your labor. You've gone through a tedious academic and professional journey, one that only can be accomplished through hard work, diligence, and determination. Know that the race that you run isn't always given to those who are swift, but to the one that perseveres until the end. So again, you should be very proud of yourselves. This is your moment, and this is your time. Pinning ceremonies have dated back to the 12th century, when knight hospitallers were honored with a Maltese pin for caring for injured soldiers. Also in 1860, when Florence Nightingale was first honored with the Red Cross pin for her work in the Crimean War. And then in 1880, when the first class of nurses at the Bellevue Hospital School of Nursing in New York were honored with pins at graduation. It's an occasion to honor you also for the successful completion of the first and major part of your education as professional nurses. This ceremony is a rite of passage that symbolizes your readiness and passage into the world to care for humanity in a professional manner. You are about to enter one of the most beloved and trusted professions that exists. You will be caring for those from birth to dignified death. I realize that when you began this journey, you made some life-altering changes. You sacrificed times with your friends and with your family to complete this program. So to all those loved ones who felt abandoned over the past 2 years, thank you. Thank you for the shoulders to cry on, the words of encouragement when the students wanted to give up, and special thanks for all of the financial support that you provided during the past 2 years. I promise you they'll pay you back. Now you get to forget those times when you thought when you couldn't even spell tachypnea or bradycardia or tachycardia, and those times when you're trying to drop insulin with steady hands when you feel the instructor's breath on the back of your neck. Those days are over. I hope that you, as you begin your work as a registered nurse after you pass boards on the very first take, you remember the faculty, the staff, and your colleagues at St. Petersburg College of Nursing fondly. For better or worse, and I know that there were both, we are part of your journey and your professional life story. You should be so proud of yourselves and for the milestone that you have reached. Again, I say congratulations and Godspeed. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Baker. It is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Rosemary Keller. Her education includes Bachelor's of Science in Nursing, Seton Hall University, South Orange, New Jersey, Master's of Science in Nursing, Adelphi University, Garden City, New York, Postmaster's Program, Oncology, Clinical Nurse Specialty Track, USF, Tampa, Florida, and PhD Adult Education with Emphasis on Curriculum and Instruction, USF, Tampa, Florida. Dr. Keller has been a nurse educator for much of her career and served as faculty at our SPC College of Nursing in the Associate's Degree in Nursing program from 2002 to 2016. She is a past Level 1 team leader and chair of the College of Nursing Curriculum Committee. Prior to her position at SPC, Dr. Keller held the joint faculty appointment of University of South Florida College of Nursing and Tampa General Hospital. She participated on the Nursing Executive Committee and developed and implemented staff development programs and also served on the Advanced Practice Council to promote clinical excellence. Dr. Keller also held the Education Specialist Patient Education position at St. Joseph's Hospital, where she coordinated, implemented, and evaluated the patient education program hospital-wide. She also served as chair of the Patient Education Committee and provided staff development in patient education. In addition, she developed and implemented critical thinking and nursing courses for nurses and participated in several research committees, including the St. Joseph's Hospital Institutional Review Board. Her doctoral dissertation, The Effects of a Critical Thinking and Clinical Decision-Making Informational Program on Critical Thinking and Clinical Decision-Making Skills of Associate Degree Nursing Students, has been presented and developed into workshops throughout the country. Professionally, Dr. Keller has served as president or board member of several nursing organizations, such as the Florida Nurses Association, Sigma Theta Tau International, and Florida League for Nursing. Likewise, she has served on the board of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society, Suncoast Chapter, and advisory board of the Sarasota Chapter. During this time, she also led family and patient support groups for the American Cancer Society and Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. Given Dr. Keller's diverse and extensive nursing experience, please welcome her as our guest speaker.
Wow, that was an awesome introduction. Thank you so much. As you can see from that introduction, I've been in nursing a long time, and it has been a wonderful journey of my life, and I am so deeply honored to be invited to be the guest speaker here today. I'm almost at a loss for words, however, I have to find those words, because I'm going to be sharing some of the things that I think may guide you in your new journey as a professional nurse. I just want to share with you that I see this as a very momentous occasion for your students. Being that I was part of the faculty and we set up so many of the challenges academically for you, I know that you have run the race. It's like a marathon, one lap after another, till you finally cross the finish line. Today you have crossed the finish line, and we are all here to celebrate tremendously. I promise you, having put in all that hard work, it will pay dividends, and that you will be well prepared to be successful as you begin your professional journey. I also would like to acknowledge the dedication and the support that your family, including your spouses, partners, parents, children, they provided so that you could study for tests, complete your patient-focused nursing care plans, participate in clinical experience, and prepare numerous other scholarly projects and presentations. Dear graduates, remember, thank them for all their caring and love that they have given to you for your future. I also wish to acknowledge my very dedicated, hardworking, and caring colleagues who are over there. They have brought, they bring rich professional knowledge and experience to all of their students. These are gifted nurses who have followed the noble calling to impart generously their professional knowledge, skills, and values to enable you, the graduate, to be the very best nurse you can be. That being said, I would like to share a little bit about myself and how I chose nursing as a career. First of all, this is a story that a lot of my peers don't know, so you're part of the in crowd now. But first of all, I was born into a family dedicated to helping people get well. My father was a general practice physician, and my mother was an operating room nurse. In those days, my dad would see patients in the office, which occupied part of the basement in our house where we lived. He also performed surgery at St. Francis Hospital and delivered babies at the Margaret Haig Hospital in Jersey City, New Jersey. Meanwhile, my mother ran the office. She maintained all the supplies, and she also served as triage nurse for the patients calling on the phone or knocking on the door looking for medical care. I just want to say I was fascinated with all of this patient-centered activity continuously going on. I started my nursing career very early, at the tender age of 6. I used to go out and chat with the patients while they were waiting to see my father. I would talk to them about asking them if they were sick and reassuring them that my dad was a good doctor and would make them better. There is nothing like a little public relation advertising going on from a very biased 6-year-old. You've got the picture, right? I'm told that the patients were amused, or I hope that they were amused. I knew from very early on I wanted to be a nurse. In senior year in high school, I took the National League of Nursing entrance exam and was accepted to St. Vincent's Hospital down in New York City, which was a very, very popular and well-respected institution, and they had a wonderful diploma nursing program. I was thrilled to receive this letter of acceptance, and my parents were very pleased too. But they suggested I consider taking it a step further. They said, why don't you think about going for your BSN? We'd like you to have a college degree. So I said, okay, but I did not fully appreciate what visionaries they were. How could I have known at the age of 17 that the nursing profession was going to advance and mature into becoming such a scholarly and highly esteemed profession? I thank my parents every day for their foresight and wisdom. I wish to share with you one more story about my nursing education. Although I was a student of nursing years ago, before the implementation of the nursing process, if you can imagine how long ago that was, okay, the volume of knowledge that we needed to learn was huge. So my best friend, Jane, who was also a nursing student with me, we came up with a plan on how to digest all this huge volume of knowledge. Whenever we had a test in medical surgical nursing, Jane and I would study at my house, and we would write down all the questions that we would have about the medical surgical content. Then when my dad would finish his office hours about 10 o'clock at night, we would bombard him with all of our questions. God bless him, he was a saint. He would sit down, he would become our teacher, he would draw us pictures of the anatomy and physiology so we had a visual image of knowing what was going on with the disease process. I want to share with you, Jane and I did very well on our test. And we went on, of course, to pass our licensure exam. How blessed I was to have such a wonderful friend as Jane and to have such caring and incredible support from my mom and dad. Let's fast forward. I got married and spent the next 10 years raising 5 children. I returned to nursing after taking an RN refresher course. With all the demands of raising a family, I worked part-time as a private duty nurse and part-time in a doctor's office as a nurse. It wasn't until I arrived in Florida in 1982 that I had my first full-time job as a bedside staff nurse, and this was at Sarasota Memorial Hospital on the oncology unit. And there I worked for the next 5.5 years. From there, I went on to teach at the State College of Florida. I went to St. Joseph's Hospital, on to the University of Florida, and then lastly to St. Petersburg College. So I worked a total of 34 years as a nurse, which is a long time, but I feel like it's been a wonderful career every step of the way. My career as a nurse and educator has provided me with many experiences and insights. I wish to share with you the ones that I think will be most beneficial to you as you embark on your professional journey. I call these experiences and insights the 5 pearls of wisdom. The first pearl of wisdom is prepare well for your NCLEX by becoming test wise. Don't try to wing it. I told you the story about my friend Jane and I and how we studied for our exams. You need to study for yours too. Using resources is central, and today you have so many resources between the ATI and NCLEX practice question books and various sites with test-taking tips. So make sure you understand and answer the practice questions. The more practice questions you answer, the more familiar you will be with the concepts that are going to be tested, and the more familiar you will be with the way they word these questions, so that when you sit down to take your NCLEX, you'll have a lot more confidence in how you're answering these questions. I also suggest after graduation that you set aside a specific time each day to review the content. It takes approximately 4 to 8 weeks to review and to do it when you, and then when you feel ready to take the exam, then make an appointment to go ahead and do that. Much of the nursing knowledge will still be fresh in your mind if you take the exam 4 to 8 weeks after you graduate. The second pearl of wisdom is first obtain a job and then find a mentor or mentors. These are nurses who you admire for their knowledge and professional skills. These are nurses who genuinely care for the patients and who role model the kind of nurse that you want to be. You will need a mentor, especially in the first 6 to 12 months on the job. The learning curve is very, very steep, and you will need answers to many questions, and you may need assistance with some skills that you haven't had a chance to practice. I learned the importance of having mentors during my first full-time job at Sarasota Memorial on the oncology unit. I had 3 very experienced nurses and a wonderful clinical nurse specialist educator who I could go to with all of my questions and occasionally ask them for help in performing procedures that some of them I had never performed before. I'm eternally grateful for their kindness and patience in helping me navigate this very stressful time in my first job. The third pearl of wisdom, and this won't come as a surprise to some of you, but it's join your professional nursing organization. And that would be the American Nurses Association and the Florida Nurses Association. This organization will keep you informed about what professional nursing issues are important, both nationally and statewide. It will provide you with an opportunity to get involved and participate in public health issues. The organization will offer you many educational opportunities to continue to maintain competency in nursing knowledge and skills. As a professional nurse, I've been a member for ANA and FNA for 34 years. I've also served as a board member in both Sarasota and Hillsborough District. As an ANA and FNA member, I attended a number of conventions, traveling and meeting nursing professionals and theorists from around the country, around the state. It was a very special, enriching experience. For example, I became acquainted with Dr. Imogene King. Some of you may remember, she was the theorist who developed she's a nationally renowned theorist who developed a goal attainment theory. Dr. Imogene King would sometime come to visit my class at SPC and talk to the students about her theory. Now, how good can that be, having the theorist there to tell you about her theory? Was wonderful. Another well-known celebrity I met in FNA was Dr. Suzanne Smith. She was the editor for the Journal of Nursing Administration and Nursing Educator. She helped me publish some of my dissertation work on critical thinking. Another famous person I met was Dr. Greta Stiles. She was past president of American Nurses Association. She had been the dean of the University of California School of Nursing. She was president of the International Nursing Association, and she was also a member of the original committee that set up the standards for magnet hospitals. The only thing I can say is when you join ANA and FNA, you are going to be with many professionals and leaders in the field of nursing. You will be with the movers and the shakers. After joining ANA and FNA, then I strongly encourage you to join your specialty nursing organization. And lastly, upon invitation from Sigma Theta Tau International, which is the Nursing Honor Society, I encourage you to join. At SPC, we have a Sigma Theta Tau International chapter called Upsilon Psi. By joining and participating your professional organization, you will be with the movers and the shakers in the field of nursing. So please consider that. The fourth pearl of wisdom is practicing resiliency, okay? Most of us have had a few setbacks in life, which at the time may have been very painful and shook our confidence, but learning to be resilient and able to bounce back as a stronger person and wiser person may be one of the most important lessons we're going to learn in life. If you get knocked down, don't stay down. Use your experience and wisdom as a learning opportunity and use it to guide you through the next stage of your professional life. In my life, I have faced a number of setbacks, and fortunately, every time I was able to bounce back. For example, I encountered a setback when I was working at the University of South Florida in the joint faculty position with Tampa General. I experienced what I refer to as a philosophical difference with an administrator, and as a result, my contract was terminated. It was very upsetting to me. Anyway, within 2 weeks, Dr. Jean Wartock, who was the dean of the St. Pete College nursing program, she stopped by my office. She was working on her dissertation on critical thinking and wanted to ask me a few questions. During her visit, she indicated that SPC was starting their BSN nursing program and she needed to fill 3 faculty positions. She asked, did I know anybody who might want one of these jobs? And I said, well, yes, as a matter of fact, I would like to have one of these jobs. So, as they say, the rest is history. I have been at the college for 14 years, and I have loved every single minute of it. And I'm really proud to be here. So I share this story as a message to each one of you. There will likely be setbacks and disappointments in your life, but it is how you deal with them and bounce back that really counts. I'm coming to the end. Last but not least, the fifth pearl of wisdom invites you to set goals in your life. As a lifelong tennis player, I always said, keep your eye on the ball, set priorities, and follow through with them. This is true in your personal, professional, and community life. If you wish to be an advanced nurse practitioner or a nursing educator, administrator, or researcher, you're going to need to continue your education. I encourage you to go for the gold. This means putting your whole heart and physical being into the contest. Set the goals you want to reach. Nothing is impossible, but you must be committed to achieving your dreams and shoot for the moon. Even if you miss, you're still going to be up there with the stars. Set your sights high and continue to work towards your goals. In conclusion, I hope I have left you with some ideas about how to navigate the road ahead in your professional career. You are at the beginning of an exciting professional journey. Pass the NCLEX, get the job of your dreams, be successful at it. Go on for your BSN, maybe your MSN, and for the super achievers, go right on for your Doctor of Nursing Practice or your PhD. Each level of education opens up new opportunities for your professional career and new opportunities for personal growth and for helping others. So in closing, I wish to again congratulate all of you wonderful, hardworking graduates and their dedicated families. And I encourage all of you to go celebrate this special occasion with much joy and happiness. You have earned it. Oh my goodness. Thank you. Thank you so much, Richard. I'm speechless.
Thank you, Dr. Keller. The pinning ceremony is a time-honored nursing school tradition dating back before the turn of the 20th century. Traditionally, nursing students have conducted a pinning ceremony to mark the passage from the student nurse role into the professional practice role. The student nurses are being pinned by their clinical instructor as a way of symbolizing the welcoming of the student into the profession as colleagues. The yellow rose symbolizes life, the beauty of the rose is perfection, and the thorns represent the difficulties overcome to reach perfection. This rose also symbolizes knowledge, and the buds represent the students, as their knowledge is just the beginning. The yellow rose also symbolizes honor and loyalty to the profession, as well as joy and gladness. Graduate nurses, always wear your school pin with pride. Let it serve as a constant reminder, not only to yourselves, but also to your patients, family, and friends, of your desire, perseverance, and the dedication you have made to serve others. May I please request the presence of Dr. Susan Baker to the podium to begin the pinning. Faculty, please prepare to pin your students.
Dr. Jose Alejandro's clinical group. Anne Marie Johnson. Sarah Scales. Thank you. Miriam Abdallah. Anelia Mitchell. Jared Goldman. Jonathan Rinke. Mrs. Rhonda Anderson's clinical group. Tabitha Bates. Jessica Benson. Victoria Romero. Carrie McIntosh. Pablo Quintana. Kevin Dry. Mrs. Leah Churchill's clinical group. Wilmarie Lima. Tamura Bucher. Katrina Hostin. Crystal Banks. Nicole Lee. Huffnagel. Mrs. Karen Emerly's clinical group. Rose Saka. Linda Burke. Catherine Anderson. Julia Green. Cindy Spire. Frankie Luster. Jonathan Green. Mrs. Diane Jinks Clinical Group. Karina Massey. Kelly Smith. Lisa Kelly. Lindsay Dosey. Lauren LoMonaco. Amy Rutherford. Sasan Ochoa. Amy Walston. Christy Ann Goh. Mrs. Lisa Johnson's clinical group. Kaylee Braden. April Alacargote. Lindsay Whiteside. Patty Schulmeister. Pon Visayalad. Eric Gotchling. Norbert Mugo. Mm-hmm. Mrs. Deborah Laumann's clinical group. Lindsay Dodson. Katie Shaman. Carrie Carpenzano. Kaylee Brown. Jacqueline Eklund. Jarrett Lyons.
Miranda, is that right? Right. Duffy.
David Miranda. Diana Morris. Jessica Lewis. Mrs. Mary Lewis's clinical group. Jacqueline Jardine. Thaddeus Vaughn. Shay Greaves. Kathleen Mason. Christina Johnson. Yeah. Kellyanne Giaferta. Amy Barr. Rachel Lewis. Javier Ramirez. Sempong Liweha. Ms. Gina McCabe's clinical group. Jessica Spady. Anna Smith. Borami Hong. Lisa Householder.
Mrs. Jennifer Mistretta's clinical group. Melvin Price. Kelsey Elizabeth Timmons. Marilyn Harms. Michael Patag. Greg Gibbo. Mrs. Christina Patterson's clinical group. Richard Higgins. Joe Fidon. Ajibu Jallo. Olivia Igo. Barbara Matthews. Gina Fofica. Pamela Landas. Miss Kathleen Renshaw's clinical group. Raquel Wilkes. Colleen DeRosa.
Thank you.
Brianna Lynn Cremard. Gina Jackson. Shelby Dagan Thompson. Laura Jennings. Mr. Mark Rosales, Clinical Group. Donald Kennington, Jr. Jamie Walker. Julie Mullard. Amanda Pollard. Gerard Scatiglio. Heidi Altenberg. Latasha Wilson. Deirdre Fitzsimmons. Yanira Rosario. Leanne Rodriguez. Jessica Kowalik. Aisha Reed. Mrs. Amy Ross, Clinical Group. Lacey Bell Castro. Willette Young. Thank you. Rebecca George. Annie Vandemar. Crystal Keen. Shannon Barrett. Brenda Beard. Janelle Ippolito. Kelsey Smalley. Tina Coleman. Karen C. Mrs. Ariona Tace, Clinical Group. Monica Copeland. Dawn Doyle. Edgar Ariano. Ms. Ruth Velasquez, Clinical Group. Henry Walter Samuel III. Ada Fernandez. Lauren Hazlett. Meredith Suzanne Hammond. Hetal Patel. Devin LaPlume. Kaylee Moore. Blair Toledo. Kayla Cavicchio.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Associate Degree in Nursing Fall Class of 2016. This is what academic excellence at St. Petersburg College looks like. Please be seated.
Almost there. First, may we have a moment of silence. I'd like to take this opportunity to remember the friends and family who could not finish this journey with us. To all of those we have lost along the way, in honor of their memory, let us offer this moment of silence. Thank you. Now, graduates, please stand and recite with me the Florence Nightingale Pledge. I solemnly pledge myself before God and in the presence of this assembly to faithfully practice my profession of nursing. I will do all in my power to make and maintain the highest standards and practices of my profession. I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping in the practice of my calling. I will assist the physicians in their work and will devote myself to the welfare of my patients, my family, and my community. I will endeavor to fulfill my rights and privileges as a good citizen, and take my share of responsibility in promoting the health and welfare of my community. I will constantly endeavor to increase my knowledge and skills in nursing and to use them wisely. I will zealously seek to nurse those who are ill, wherever they may be, and whenever they are in need. I will be active in assisting others in safeguarding and promoting the health and happiness of mankind. Thank you. You may be seated. In closing, on behalf of the Student Nurses Association, I'd like to congratulate once again the graduating seniors of December 2016. Your life's an occasion. May you rise to it. One last thing before we depart. Graduates, please remain behind momentarily for the group picture. Family and faculty, please, as quickly as possible, clear the middle section for the photo.